Hey everybody, Adam Bobrow here with another episode of Ask a Pro Anything presented by Andro. And for this episode, we've got an up-and-coming superstar that you might recognize, as she is a 7-time national youth champion of the Netherlands, 2010 European youth champion, and a 2017 European Championships team's bronze medalist. It's Britt Eerland. Sarah Danut wants to know, which table tennis player do you usually lose to in Mario Kart?
To be honest, many players.
Can you name a few?
In a Dutch team, we played like for 1 month Mario Kart, and I lost against most. In the beginning I won, but afterwards I lost. And of course, also Sarah has a Nintendo Switch, and I lost also against her. But you know, it's for fun, it's to connect with people, so I keep playing.
So basically, Sarah's not special is what you're saying.
No, I think, I'm not sure though in Mario Kart. She plays also a lot of other games and I think she's quite good at it. But Mario Kart, who knows? But just saying, I'm not that good.
Nice try, Sarah. Zach Rowan wants to know, do you have a big family? Are you close with them?
Ooh, I'm very close with my family. I think family is important. They support you no matter what. So, and I get their support. Always when I come back for tournaments, the first thing I do is go visit my grandparents. Like, they are so cute and adorable and I like them so much. So yeah, family is important. And you can say it's big, but I wouldn't say it's that big. Like, my parents divorced and then both of them got a new partner. And my father made another child, so I have a half-brother, Benjamin. He's very cute also. They really follow me. Like, today I won my match and directly my father, my stepfather, my boyfriend, they all like text me like, oh, I saw you won, you played. Also my grandmother, she really follows me, like really strict, and she supports me very well. So directly I speak with everybody.
Violon Electrique wants to know, do you like to meditate before a match? Do you like classical music?
What I do a little bit as meditation is like, I dance and I try to feel my body and relax and feel everything that I can use my body in the match, but also in my mental game. Because if you are in the here and now, it's easier to focus at the here and now, it's easier to focus on the match. If else, I probably will think too much like, oh, what if I lose or what if I win? So I prefer to be in the here and now and focus on my body and just fight my match.
Zach Herrera Monge wants to know, what's your biggest fear when playing table tennis? Saludos desde Costa Rica. Greetings from Costa Rica.
Thank you for that. My greatest fear, I think also it really depends again against who you're playing or what the situation is at. What I'm really bad at is like to qualify for tournaments. Like if it's like 9-9 or 2-2 and it doesn't matter when, I can play really good because it's like it's some different kind of pressure. But when I have to qualify for something like 3 months before, then I make the story way bigger in my head. So, and then I get a fear like when I'm playing, like, oh, I must win this match because then I can qualify and then I have this and this and this, and then it gets too big for me.
Hemel.upudu wants to know, can you please sing a Dutch song for us?
Yes, I was afraid for that one. Beter leven, jij bent bewijs op een amazing. Jij bent bewijs, je juiste reden. Jij bent bewijs hoe het hoort te zijn. Jij bent bewijs, niks te bewijzen.
Eric Glad wants to know, where did you get your amazing dance moves from? I must learn them, wink wink.
Yes, I already tried to teach him. So that's probably why he asked. And of course, I will teach you again, no problem. If you call, I go come deliver. I no go fall in your hand in ever. So now me, you could love forever. I'm a cocky, no feeble letter. I'm a Angeli Angelina.
I'm a Angeli Angelina. Strange Blue Smurf wants to know, which is the best win in your career?
It's Liuja from Austria. But it's more because like I played against her in the Olympics and we were in a team event and I was down 2-0 and I was thinking like, really, I'm not gonna lose 3-0 on the Olympics. And then I came back, found a tactic, I came back to 2-2 and then I lost 12-10. So I was really depressed like 2-3 months afterwards because then the team also lost. And then on the European Championships 2017, in the quarterfinal, I had to play against them again. And at 2-0, I had to play against Liuja again. And I was really thinking like, this is payback. This is my revenge from the Olympics. So I used the same tactic and I was really on fire and I beat her 3-0 and I'm still really proud of it.
All right, this has been another fun episode of Ask a Pro Anything presented by Andro with Britt Eerland. Britt, anything you want to say to your fans?
No, I think there have been enough questions. And of course, if you have questions, keep asking them.
Cool, you know how to reach her. You saw her social media at the beginning of the video. Britt, thanks for doing this.
No problem.
Keep watching the world tour.